We'll be continuing with introduction to various cosmetic preparations, part B. So in the previous session, that is introduction to various cosmetic preparations, part A, we had dealt with the introduction, definition, about the classification of cosmetics, main ingredients of cosmetics and its properties, plant material which are commonly used for cosmetics and the functional raw materials and some of the formulations which are commonly used as cosmetics for skin, creams, contents of cream, the procedure of making cream, and regarding lotions, its preparation methodology, powder, and regarding cosmetics for hair and nails and cosmetics for eye. Then we had dealt in detail about the preparation of face powder, compact powder, rouges, cold cream and vanishing. So today we will be continuing with the rest of the cosmetic preparations. So first of all we have eyeshadow. Eyeshadow is used to give a background color to the eyes and it is to be applied to the eyelids. There are a large number of shades which are used, but more commonly used ones are blue, grey, green, white, gold, etc. And these eyeshadows are prepared in wax bases in the form of creams, emulsions, sticks, loose powders or as compressed powders. Next one is eyebrow pencils. So eyebrow pencils are hard crayons, usually black, and are used for darkening the eyebrows. They are manufactured by the pencil manufacturers and are available in wide range of colors. The eyebrow pencils contain a high proportion of waxes to make them hard so that they can be molded as thin stick and sharpened to a point. Next one is mascara. It's a dark pigmented preparation used on the eyelashes and thicken their appearance, and it is usually applied with a brush. So some of the properties, it should be having the following qualities, that is, it must be non-toxic, it must be non-irritating to the eyes, it must not run, cake or cause eyelashes to stick together, and it should be applied easily and evenly. Moving on to the preparation of lipsticks. Without the inclusion of lipsticks in the bag of cosmetics, it is considered as an incomplete bag. So its lipsticks are usually manufactured as molded sticks and basically consist of coloring pigments dissolved or dispersed in a fatty base, which is made stiff by including wax so as to form a stick. Suitable perfumes and flavors are also incorporated. So depending on the cost of raw materials used in the manufacture of lipsticks, they are available in different varieties. Have the following qualities. It should be non-toxic and non-irritating, and it should be free from gritty particles. It should be easily applicable and easily removable if need arises. It should have good odor. It should give shiny and smooth appearance, and it should not dry on storage. It should be free from sweating, and it should maintain its lip color long after its application, and the stick should not break during use, and it should maintain its firmness till the whole of it is used up. So the formula for making lipsticks are as beeswax, commonly white in color, 33 gram is taken, and acetyl alcohol, 12 gram, sesame oil, 20 ml, castor oil, 29 gram, perfume, 2 ml, and tetrabromfluorescein, 4 gram. So the procedure of preparation of lipsticks are as: dissolve the tetrabromfluorescein in castor oil, melt the beeswax, acetyl alcohol and sesame oil together. Mix the two solutions and add perfume. Mix thoroughly so as to get a uniform mass. Transfer the mass prepared into the cavities. Next one is shaving media. Shaving media are really not the cosmetics for hair, but they are used to remove unsightly hair. So various types of shaving media includes pre-shave products, shaving products and aftershave products. So lather shaving creams are semi-solid preparations which are used by men to help in removing the hair from face. These creams are packed in collapsible tubes and are used with the help of shaving brush to produce a lather on the face, thus soften the beard and hold individual hair erect for close shaving. Rated 40 to 60% soap solution in glycerol and water, and the soap is formed with saponification of fatty acids with alkalis. Glycerin is extensively used as humectant in this type of shaving creams, and the ingredients commonly used in the preparation of shaving creams include stearic acid, tallow, stearin, coconut oil, olive oil, peanut oil, caustic soda, caustic potash, glycerin, alcohol, lanolin, borax, boric acid, propylene glycol, aromatic water, and water. Coloring and flavoring agents may be added according to the choice and depending on the nature of the ingredients. So the qualities of a good lather shaving cream are as: it should be non-irritating to the skin, it should not change its viscosity according to the temperature, it should be smooth, soft and non-lumpy, it should have good wetting properties, and it must produce rich lather composed of small bubbles that do not dry on face too rapidly, and only small quantities of cream should be required to produce good lather, that is, it should be economical, it should be non-abrasive to the razor blade and easily rinsed from the razor and face. So the formula for making lather shaving cream is as: stearic acid 38.8 gram, coconut oil 9, potassium hydroxide 8 gram, sodium hydroxide 1.6 gram, glycerol 11.6 gram, water 30.3 ml, and the preservatives are taken in sufficient quantity, perfumes also sufficient quantity. So the method of preparation is as: melt half of the stearic acid with coconut oil over a water bath. To this, add alkalis with continuous stirring to saponify the oils. After saponification, add the remaining of stearic acid and separately warm the glycerol and half of the water to about 65 degrees Celsius and add slowly to the saponified liquid with continuous stirring until a creamy paste is formed. Heat the remaining amount of water to about 44 degrees Celsius and add quickly to the cream with continuous stirring. Add the preservatives and perfume, stir so as to mix the slowly. We have antiperspirants and deodorants. So, the sweat glands secrete perspiration which varies from person to person. Some individuals secrete sweat which is of offensive order, and in certain cases it is considerably colored also. So, the correction of body odor is carried out by antiperspirants and deodorants. So, antiperspirants and deodorants are cosmetic products which are used to reduce underarm and body odor, and the antiperspirants inhibit the flow of perspiration. Deodorants inhibit the formation of malodor in perspiration by suppressing bacterial growth or cover the malodor with a more pleasing one. Many products have both antiperspirant and deodorant activity. Antiperspirants contain substances which have astringent action and reacts with protein of the skin, causing coagulation accompanied by swelling at the opening of the sweat glands, thus blocking the openings and reducing the flow of sweat. Antiperspirants and deodorants are available as clear liquids for direct spray or aerosol application, powder, sprays, sticks, creams and lotions. The salts of various metals such as aluminium, iron, chromium, lead, mercury, zinc and zirconium have astringent properties which precipitate the proteins, but all of them cannot be used because of either discoloration or toxic effects. But salts of ammonium and zinc are commonly used. To protect the skin from toxic effects and clothes from rotting, a combination of salt may be used. The liquid antiperspirants consist of an aqueous or hydroalcoholic solution of an astringent salt to which a small quantity of humectant, a perfume, a dispersing agent for the perfume and a deodorant is added. So the formula for a deodorant powder is as: salicylic acid 2 gram, boric acid 40 gram, talc 48 gram, zinc stearate 10 gram. And the formula for liquid antiperspirant is: alcohol 50 ml, propylene glycol 5 ml, hexachloroprofen 0.1 gram, aluminium chlorohydroxide 15 gram, water 29.9 ml and perfume quantity sufficient. The method of preparation is as: Mix the alcohol and propylene glycol. To this, dissolve hexachlorophene and perfume. Separately dissolve aluminium chloride. Add the solution slowly to the alcoholic solution. Keep the mixed solution in a closed container for at least 48 hours and then filter the solution and fill it in suitable container. Moving on to the next one, that is shampoos. A shampoo may be defined as a preparation contents which when used will remove grease, dirt and debris from the hair and scalp without seriously affecting the hair, scalp or other parts of the body. So apart from cleansing action, it must leave the hair fragrant, lustrous, soft and manageable. Though the shampoos act as detergents like that of detergent cakes, but along with these properties, they behave as cosmetics also. Generally, shampoos are water-soluble solutions or suspensions prepared by dissolving cleansing agents in a suitable liquid to which other agents are added to improve the functions of the shampoo. So mostly synthetic detergents are used for this purpose, to which soap is also added, but good shampoos do not contain any soap. So the properties of a shampoo are as, a good shampoo should be having the following qualities. That is, it should be effective in small amounts. It should remove grease, dirt and skin debris from the hair and scalp. It should be non-toxic, non-irritant and should not damage the skin and sensitive organs like eyes if accidentally it comes in contact with the eyes. And it should not produce adequate foam in soft as well as in hard water, and it should give pleasant flavor after its use. It should be easily washable with water and it should leave the hair lustrous, soft and manageable. So therefore shampoos are widely used for this purpose, which are available in different forms, and they are commonly as clear liquid shampoos, baby shampoos, medicated dandruff shampoos, soap shampoos, liquid cream or lotion shampoos, powder shampoos, gel shampoos, cream or paste shampoos. So various types of additives in shampoos are opacifiers, solubilizing agents, thickening agents, conditioning agents and preservatives. So the composition of a shampoo is usually a principal surfactant will be there, that's anionic type. Non-ionic surfactant has a sufficient cleansing property but have low foaming. Cationic are toxic and so anionic are preferred. Then secondary surfactant, that is anionic or ampholytic detergent. They modify detergent and surfactant properties of principal surfactant. Third one is anti-dandruff agents, which may contain selenium, cadmium sulfide, ZPTO. Conditioner, lanolin, oil, herbal extract or amino acids. Then pearlescent agents, that is substituted for methyl coumarins. Then sequestrants, EDT is added because calcium, magnesium salts absorbs cause dullness by deposition of calcium and magnesium soaps on hair shaft. So moving on to the various types of additives used in shampoos. Opacifiers. Opacifiers are used to make the shampoo opaque. So such substances include esters such as glycol and glyceryl stearate and higher alcohol such as cetyl and stearyl alcohol. Stearate soaps and waxy alkylamides such as stearic amides are also added. And in case of solubilizing agents are used to solubilize poorly soluble substance so as to get a clear shampoo. Solubilizing agents used include ethyl alcohol, glycerol, propylene glycol. Surfactants are also used as solubilizing agents. Third one is thickening agents. Thickening agents are used viscosity of the shampoo and to provide the desired consistency to the preparation. Sodium stearate and stearic amides are excellent thickening agents for cream type shampoos. Polyvinyl alcohol, methyl cellulose and sodium alginate are also used for this purpose. Conditioning agents are used to improve the manageability and the texture of the hair. Various oils, fatty alcohols, glycerol, esters, humectants and protein derivatives are used for this purpose. Lanolin and its derivatives are also extensively used as hair conditioners, and certain surfactants are also used as hair conditioners. And the preservatives which are commonly added are shampoos prepared with surfactants must be suitably preserved, because with such preparation it may lead to bacterial and mold growth. Methyl paraben and propyl paraben are commonly used preservatives in shampoos. So I would like coconut oil shampoo. So the formula is as: coconut oil 37 gram, potassium hydroxide 29 gram, water 5 ml, glycium quantity sufficient. And formula for cream type shampoo includes sodium lauryl sulfate 25 gram, stearic acid 6.5 gram, lanolin 0.25 gram. Caustic soda 1 gram, cetyl alcohol 0.5 gram, water 67 and the coloring agent quantity sufficient, perfume quantity sufficient. So the method of preparation of a shampoo is as follows: dissolve cetyl alcohol, sodium lauryl sulfate, stearic acid and lanolin in about 80% water by heating in a water bath. Separately dissolve caustic soda in remaining amount of water and heat almost to the same temperature as the previous one. Then mix the two solutions with stirring, and when the solution cools down, add the coloring agent and perfume. Mix thoroughly so as to get a homogeneous product. So some of the other methods which are used as cosmetics are hair dressing, which includes brilliant dyes, hair conditioners, hair tonics, hair waving and hair straightening preparation and anti-dandruff preparations. So the characteristics of a good hair dressing are as: it should be having good grooming action, it should provide luster to the hair without greasiness, it should be non-toxic to the skin, it should provide some degree of hair conditioning and should provide anti-dandruff action and should have good wetting properties. And these products, the products used for this purpose were homemade, commonly prepared with vines, herbs, animal and plant byproducts in the olden days. But nowadays, along with homemade products, newer products with good results are introduced in the market, the demand of which is increasing day by day. So hair not only acts as a protective covering for the head, but it is also an attractive feature. So both of these factors, that is protection and attraction, are best provided by a healthy hair. So other preparations which are commonly used for hair includes brilliant dyes. So these are used to impart luster to the hair and also for keeping the hair in place. Liquid brilliant dyes are sprayed on the hair with an atomizer after the hair has been waved. Hair conditioners are used to make hair manageable, glossy and of soft texture. They are generally used for those hair which are damaged by too frequent shampooing, hair straightening, bleaching or dyeing. So hair rinses are applied to the hair after shampooing, which film that shampoo may leave. So after rinsing, they leave the hair too soft to touch. So cream rinses may contain proteins, anti-dandruff compounds and temporary dyes also. Next one is hair tonics. So hair tonics are the preparations which are applied to the hair for curing baldness, relieving oily or dry skin and to prevent or cure dandruff. And hair tonics generally contain a combination of at least two or three ingredients, that is sebaceous gland stimulant, a rubefacient and an antiseptic. Hair tonic should be rubbed into the scalp at night, which should be shampooed out in the morning. It must be stated on the label preparations that longer the preparation is left on the scalp, better would be the results. Move on to the next one, that is hair waving and hair straightening preparations. So these solutions generally consist of thick colloidal solutions of gum caraya, gum acacia, gum tragacanth, gelatin, Irish moss or algin, usually with an addition of alkali carbonates or borax, sulfonated oil, certain amine bases, sometimes shellac, glycerin, glycols or alcohol. The method is quite simple. The gum is soaked in water overnight and next day it is heated to almost boiling and strained to get a mucilage. It isn't cool to room temperature and add the other ingredients either directly or previously dissolved in water. Allow the preparations to stand for about 3 days to observe any change in viscosity. The viscosity of the preparation should not be changed during shelf life. As there are chances of bacterial growth, so a suitable preservatives must be added. So the formula of making a hair wave set are gum tracker can ribbons 12 gram, warm water 1.5 liter, perfume 4 ml and sodium benzoate 1 gram. And the method of preparation is as dissolve sodium benzoate in warm water and add gum tracker. Put to stand overnight with occasional stirring. Then pass the solution through a cheesecloth so as to remove lumps. Dissolve perfumes in alcohol and add it to the tracker can solution. Add the color and mix thoroughly so as to get. The viscosity of the preparation can be adjusted by increasing or decreasing the quantity of water used. Hair straightening products are closely related to hair weaving products. So almost the same process is used to straighten the hair. So the next one is hair dyes. Hair dyes are classified according to the duration of action as temporary, semi-permanent or permanent dyes. So similarly, the coloring products which are classified are as bleaching agents, temporary coloring agents, permanent coloring agents and natural organic dyes. So hair coloring products include dyes containing creams, shampoos or rinses prepared by using substances obtained from plants, metallic compounds and mixtures of these two types of substance. The most commonly used organic material from plant origin is called as henna. So the characteristics of a hair dye are: it should be non-irritating to the hair and skin, it should be non-toxic, it should be able to color the hair shaft without damaging it, it should be stable and should not change its color when exposed to air, sunlight, water, shampoo or hair conditioning agents. And some of the other preparations are depilators and anti-dandruff preparations. So depilators are used to often untaping or rinsing after a short time of application. So when the hair are removed by chemical methods, it's called as depilation. And when the relatively intact unwanted hair are removed by plucking, electrolysis or X-ray, it is called as epilation. So moving on to the next one, that is anti-dandruff preparation. Dandruff is a scaly disease of the scalp and a product which clears the scalp of adherent debris and regulates the amount of residual scalp and hair oils to retain healthy condition of the scalp is known as shin. The sebaceous glands surround the hair and secrete their oil along the shaft of the hair. So at times this oily secretion is mixed with decomposition matter from the cells, which is horn-like in nature and is forced to the surface of the scalp. So the secretion may be deficient or excessive. If hygienic care of the scalp is not taken, it may result in bacterial growth also. The infection may result from barber shops, hat shops, public room. Dandruff may lead to loss of hair, but the exact reason for this is not known. Dandruff can be checked but not remedied by shampooing. Proper cleansing of the scalp is of great importance. This should be combined with treatment designed to reduce or stimulate the secretions of the sebaceous glands. Applications of germicide is also helpful in some cases. Mechanical massage or thorough brushing of the hair with a clean brush both before and after shampoo is advisable. The free washing the hair is very important. If large quantity of dandruff is present, hair should be washed daily with shampoo for about a week. If the washing may be done after 2 or 3 days. While using shampoo, preferably it should be allowed to remain on the hair for a quarter to half an hour, which is then washed with warm water. So after complete drying of the hair, it should be massaged and brushed thoroughly to increase the blood supply. So some of the various types of shampoos which are available as anti-dandruff preparations are as discussed here. So the formula for an anti-dandruff includes selenium disulfide 2.5 gram, surfactant 17 gram, inert stabilizer 5.2 gram and water 75.3 ml. and the four dandruff remover are betanaphthol 1 gram, alcohol 48 ml, then glycerin 2 ml, quilia 48 ml, perfume 0.1 ml. So Drug and Cosmetic Act 1964 deals with the rules related to drugs as well as cosmetics. So cosmetic products should not contain mercury compounds as per this act, and it should not contain more than 2 parts per million of arsenic, 20 parts per million of lead, and 100 parts per million of any heavy metal. And it should replace potentially harmful ingredients in for alternatives, and requires manufacturers to disclose specific fragrance ingredients which has been added, and it prohibits antibacterial house. So according to Ayurveda, the world's ancient science of health care and healing, works on 4 levels of body, mind and spirit. When these are in perfect harmony and beauty, ancient scriptures like Abhijnana Shakuntalam and Meghadutam of Kalidasa and many other mythology past the reference of cosmetics like tilak, kajal, agaru, etc. that were used as body decoratives. So the Ayurvedic cosmetic as cosmetics for enhancing the appearance of facial skin, cosmetics for skin care, cosmetics for skin care especially for teenagers, that is problems like acne, pimples, etc. and shampoos, soaps, powders and perfumeries, etc. and some other miscellaneous products also. Products are used mainly for tvak, that is lepa kalpana. Varnagara ganas can be used for tvak. Kushtakna ganas can be used. Eladi gana can be used. And abhyangam with any taila can be used in case of tvak. So medicinal plants which are used as moisturizers, skin tonics and anti-agings are aloe vera, that is kumari, can be used as a moisturizer, sunscreen and emollient. Curcuma longa, that is haldi, it has antiseptic, antibacterial and also helps in improves the complexion. Then glycyrrhizae glabra acts as skin whitening agent. Docus carota, that is gajar, can act as a natural toner and skin rejuvenator. Osimum sanctum, that is tulsi, can act as anti-aging, antibacterial and antiseptic. Then kasani can reduce skin blemishes. Sunscreen, that is aloe vera, can be used as moisturizer, and Ceuticum sativum, that can be used as an antioxidant. In case of suntan, Cypress rotundus, that is musta, can be used, and Moringa oleifera can be used for suntanning. Then rose can be used for toning and as well as for cooling effects. And it can also be used, that is Rosmarinus officinalis, can be used as skin rejuvenator and as cleanser. Then tula can be used as an astringent. It has antibacterial, antifungal and antiseptic properties. And for kesha, initially we had tvak. For kesha, mainly taila kalpanas are explained. Some of the kalpanas are malatyadi taila yogam, neelyadi tailam, prapondrikadi tailam. Some other formulations are also there. Neeli brangadi, brihat amlakyadi, etc. Durdura patradi can be used as an anti-dandruff agent, and lepa kalpanas are hastidandamashi, amlakyadi shiro lepanam. So the ingredients for hair care products, that is some of them and their uses are enumerated below. That is acacia, concina can be used as natural detergent and anti-dandruff. Aloe vera can be used as a cleanser and revitalizer. Azadirachta indica, that is neem, can be used to reduce hair loss and can be used as an anti-dandruff. Bacopa muneri, that is brahmi, can be used as a hair tonic, promotes hair growth. Then citrus deodara, that is devadaru, can be used as an anti-dandruff agent. Eclipta alba, that is Bhringaraja, can be used to reduce the premature graying of hair and also for alopecia. Then Emblica officinalis can be used as a toner, anti-dandruff, and it protects and reduces hair loss. Hibiscus rosa sinensis, that is shoe flower, can be used as a natural hair dye, prevent hair fall and anti-dandruff. Then Hedicum used as a it can promote hair growth. Then Lawsonia alba can be used as natural hair dye, anti-dandruff and conditioner. So for Loma, for Pakshmashada indole, Anjanam with Pushpa Kasisa is explained. And Abhyandara, some of the Abhyandara Prayogas are the usage of Amlaki Churna, Nagabala Rasayana, Brahma Rasayana, Lohadi Rasayana, Trifala Rasayana, etc. So consumers worldwide are going green, and this is especially true in the cosmetics market. Over the last few years, market has been driven by products that use natural or herbal components, and the market share of natural based products have been increasing gradually. Companies are feeling pressure to focus on sustainability and reduce their environmental footprint. Are more aware and better informed than ever before. So the Indian market has been traditionally inclined toward natural products for their beauty needs, and Indians have a history and knowledge of using natural products also. So while consumers in the rest of the world have to be educated about the benefits of natural herbs, this knowledge is well inherited in India from generations. Thank you for your patient listening.